A very warm welcome to you in Ulm. So my name is Thomas Thüm and I'm going to present you our institute, the Institute on Software Engineering and Programming Languages. So the idea of this short video is that you get an overview on our teaching and research so that you can choose your courses and also maybe think already of master's thesis topics and so on. Enjoy the video. So first of all, there's a large team behind the institute. So we have three professors, namely Matthias Tichy, who is leading the institute, Tom Frühwirth, who is the one of the three of us who is there for the longest time already, and my name is Thomas Thüm. And besides the three professors, we have many members in the working group, and this screenshot here from the website is only listing people that are either PhD students or the secretary. And we also have two postdocs, so Alexander Raschke and Katharina Junke, and I'm sorry that some of them are not visible here as pictures, in terms of pictures, but hopefully you will see them soon in reality. So what are the topics of our institute? We have two topics in the name, so one of them is programming languages. So the idea of a programming language is, of course, to communicate with a machine, right? So natural languages are designed that humans can communicate with each other, and programming languages are designed that a user can tell the machine what to do. But it's also something that recently became visible, that a programming language is indeed really a language, so that you also need to understand what was written, right? So you need to not only tell the machine what to do once, but there's a lot of maintenance. You need to see what has been implemented again and again. We have two main research areas on programming languages. One is domain-specific languages. So the idea is not to have a general purpose language that you can use for many different purposes, but rather specific to a certain domain. And we have a number of research in this area, for instance, how to build domain-specific languages, but also what are the advantages and to empirical studies in this area. We also have a strong focus on particular general purpose languages, but also declarative and functional programming languages in particular. So for instance, we have logic programming languages where you declaratively specify what you need and the actual algorithm will be encoded in the backend or will emerge from the information that you have specified. So something like this might have been, you might have seen declarative languages in bachelor studies in terms of SQL. So if you say to the database what kind of information you want, you do not need to describe how you get this information. And there's something similar with logic programming languages that we focus on. And then the other high keyword is software engineering, of course. And the idea of software engineering is to understand how to develop and operate software, and there are many aspects of this, and our research areas in particular are software configuration. So there's the recent issue of Facebook where many services have been down for a while, and this is probably most likely a software configuration issue. Then there's software evolution, so software changes over time, it evolves over time, and the question is how to deal with those changes, and there are other buzzwords for this like continuous integration and continuous software engineering. And then we look at developer experience, what means that we do experiments, that we want to understand how developers or what do developers need, how we can we improve their daily life. And then there's quality assurance, of course. Again, the example of Facebook shows that we need some kind of quality assurance to get rid of outages and so on. So to give you an overview, so this is a screenshot from our website where you can see all the courses that we have, and this is on the bottom we see all the bachelor courses. Of course, most of those are not interesting to you anymore, but nevertheless here that you can see and understand what other students have heard here from our institute. And then there are a couple of courses that you can hear either in bachelor or in master. So there might be interesting for you to see these are courses. If you haven't taken any similar courses at your university before, then you might have a look at those. And then we have courses particularly designed for the master studies, a couple of courses in winter term, summer term, or some that occur rather in an irregular manner. And then of course there are also seminars, there are practical courses, or even the master thesis. So for the software engineering master, for instance, there are particular projects, and in every term there are particular projects also from our institute, but we are also organizing those whole software engineering projects. So Alexander Raschke will be the name that you will hear a lot if you are in the master software engineering. So there are a couple of courses that we run in this term. So for instance, in bachelor, I will not focus on this too much because you're probably more interested in the master's courses. Only the seminar mentioned here is also available for master's students. We have a couple of projects, but there are also many master and bachelor level courses that are taught this term. So compiler construction, so how to actually generate compilers, or how to create compilers. And this is not only interesting if you want to build your compiler on your own, but also interesting to understand how to program. We have empirical studies where you learn how you can find out how you can answer certain questions with the right empirical methods. We have functional programming as a course, management of software projects, whether it's rather like on various topics that are relevant in software engineering and management in software engineering. We have a course, Hot Software Engineering Topics, where the goal is that people from industry and research come to our university and give a talk on their main area of expertise. And then we have web engineering and rule-based programming. So this is the Quadrocopter cap, the other way around, Quadrocopter lab. So this is where I'm right now, so where we also do our, where we have a green screen right now to do some of these fancy videos that you see here. But it's also interesting because you can use this lab also to gain practical experience with many of the research areas that I mentioned before, but then we apply it to quadrocopters, and we have this lab to explore different things with those things that might be interesting for you to have a look at this. So again, a very warm welcome from everyone in the team who is not here right now, but still they're all looking forward to meet you in courses in reality, even though in this term probably some of the courses are still online, in part at least, but we hope to see you more in the future soon. Thanks for your attention.